The Great Pyramids of Giza are without a doubt among the most awe-inspiring and enigmatic constructions ever constructed by human hands. These gigantic tombs, built over 4,500 years ago, still stand tall today as a tribute to the ancient Egyptians' tremendous building prowess. The pyramids at Giza were built between 2550 and 2490 BC. BC, as in before Christ. So how were these built without the use of modern technology? Nobody knows for certain how the pyramids were constructed. So in the absence of contemporary technology, how could the ancient Egyptians move these gigantic blocks? This is one of the greatest pyramid riddles. It was widely assumed that the Great Pyramids of Egypt were built with a gigantic external ramp. Workers, according to this theory, progressively built up a slope along the sides of the pyramids and used it to haul up massive stone blocks until the pyramid was complete. Ancient literature and archaeological evidence, including the finding of ramps near the pyramid's foundation and other Egyptian building sites, back up this ramp theory. Yet, this idea had several severe flaws. For one thing, the ramp was nowhere to be found. The ramp would have had to be nearly as tall as the pyramid itself to support a construction as large as the Great Pyramids. After intensive searching and excavation, no sign of this alleged ramp has ever been discovered. Therefore, if there was no ramp, how did the ancient Egyptians construct one of history's most remarkable architectural feats? The explanation could be found in Jean-Pierre Houdin's groundbreaking idea, which proposes that the pyramids were built with an inside spiral ramp and counterweights. So how could such a complex structure be constructed within the pyramid? Jean-Pierre Houdin, a French architect, had been enthralled by the mystery of the pyramids for years, poring over old books and dissecting every detail of their construction. Houdin believed that the key to understanding the pyramids' construction lay not outside, but inside. He proposed that the pyramids were built with an internal ramp that spiraled up into the middle of the pyramid as it was erected. This theory was revolutionary. Someone had suggested a notion that could potentially explain how the big stone blocks were hauled up the pyramid without an exterior ramp for the first time. Houdin demonstrated how the ramp could have been created using 3D modeling and simulation, and his theory received great attention and appreciation. But not everyone was convinced. Houdin's internal ramp theory. Well, that's the beauty of a mystery, isn't it? It's never really solved. What if I told you that the Great Pyramid of Giza, one of the world's most amazing and enigmatic constructions, was built with an inside spiral ramp and counterweights? This magnificent edifice may have been erected utilizing a combination of unique procedures that allowed the builders to overcome some of the most significant obstacles of pyramid construction, according to Jean-Pierre Houdin's internal ramp theory. The two primary principles at the heart of Houdin's thesis are an inside spiral ramp and the grand gallery counterbalance opposite an outward ramp. These principles may appear basic, but they solve some of the pyramid builders' most difficult issues. The internal ramp eliminates the requirement for an overly large external ramp, allowing for constant verification of pyramid geometry that would otherwise be covered by a spiraling external ramp. The straight external slope opposite the grand gallery counterweight allows the largest blocks to be lifted onto the pyramid without changing direction or requiring a large team of workers. But these notions aren't just conjecture, they're backed up by visible, physical facts. So let's get to the bottom of this pyramid to uncover its secrets. Let's go sphinxing. Jean-Pierre Houdin's ramp designs were original, but they were also supported by a reasonable quantity of visible physical evidence. The internal ramp construction of the 5th Dynasty Sun Temple of Nusir is fairly apparent. Therefore, the building concept is present in the archaeological record. The Grand Gallery also exhibits noticeable scratching and staining marks along its bottom sides, which could only have been inflicted by a considerable amount of repetitive effort. Egyptology discarded or ignored his theories out of hand. Only Egyptologist Bob Breyer, a mummy specialist with no link to the pyramids, was willing to consider Houdin and assist him in gaining access to further his research. Breyer was granted permission to ascend the Great Pyramid to photograph the notch and adjacent cavity on the northeastern corner, which corresponds to where Houdin believes the internal ramp would have turned. Nobody had offered a reasonable explanation for these intriguing facts before Houdin. Yet, after this pyramid climb, Houdin was denied permission to conduct thermal camera examinations within the cavity. The Arab Spring upheaval in 2011 added further challenges. His official affiliation with institutional Egyptology will come to an end. As we wrap up our journey through the ramp of the Great Pyramids, we hope that you've gained a newfound appreciation for this incredible feat of ancient engineering. Thank you for joining us on this wonderful journey through one of history's most enthralling mysteries, and we'll see you in the following video.